definitely, like, part of the requirement of, like, our relationship is that she gets, like, 98% of the bathroom time. So, whatever that means, dominant or submissive, as long as she has time in front of the mirror to get her shit together. Hey, everybody. I'm Susan.
And I'm Brandy.
And we are the Next Family, and today we're going to answer some questions you gave us, and we're going to give it to you straight.
Well, not totally straight.
One of the questions you asked was about butch, femme, and like sort of those roles that exist between two lovers.
And then also people in general ask us like who's the dominant, or they'll ask like, that's like a common thing that people really want to like define your relationship and figure out how to, and this isn't from you guys, I think this is just like from society, trying to understand like how...
Who's the dude?
Yeah, who's the dude?
Yeah, sort of.
So, we decided we would talk from our perspective about who we are. I'm just not a big fan of labels in any way, shape, or form. I think that we are ever evolving. I know for myself, you know...
Brandy's a total femme.
I am. But I used to date guys, and...
It's kind of like GMO.
Are you finished, or...?
Almost. Okay.
Oh, she's finished now. Okay. Until no. I start talking.
No. Just wait.
So I used to date guys, and this one guy I dated, who's now like actually my best friend, well, Susan's my best friend, but he's a good friend. Never forget these videos.
Yeah.
But when I was with him, I was very submissive and very, it was kind of like he
I like that she's looking to me to find out what she was like with her last boyfriend. I was very, how was I in my relationship with that guy?
He made all the plans, he was kind of in charge, and I was like his girlfriend, you know what I mean? And I was also pretty little, I was also pretty young at the time too. But I was like, I'm not, like, with him, it's like, I wouldn't fix the TV, I wouldn't, like, set up the cable or the, you know, I don't know, the speakers, I can't even say what they are. I do that now in our relationship, because she is like, I'm not good with the technology, and so I'm like, okay, I can figure this out. I'm like, under there, figuring it out.
Yeah, that's probably true, because I'm like, I guess I am, like, more the dominant, but like, even to say those words out loud feels like, am I really?
Yeah, but she isn't. Yeah, but like you'd think, oh, well then Brandy probably cooks and bakes, and I don't, I'm horrible. Like I almost burned the house down.
Multiple times.
Yeah. I feel like we have literally, without talking about it, have found our places. Definitely agree with Susan that I'm like more the femme in the relationship. I mean, are you butch?
I think at this point, I'm gonna put myself on that. If I was gonna have to flip a coin, I would put myself on that.
Oh, versus coin. The other, right? But like,
yeah, I'm dead to femme. And if somehow I had ended up with some sort of more of a butch, do people even use this word anymore? Well, dominant. If I had ended up with more of a dominant type of woman, I might have ended up a little more feminine. Do you think?
I think that's exactly it. Like, I think that
I think it's a dynamic. You know what I mean? Like, you don't just have a relationship with yourself.
Yeah.
Well, maybe some people do. And in that case, you know, get out a little more.
I think, like, that's, I guess, why I go back to labeling, is that I think as soon as you start to kind of put those labels and requirements on yourself, then you're not open to changing and being flexible. And I think it's kind of amazing watching male-female relationships and seeing like men staying home with the kids, and that might seem really like, you know, I don't know, like not manly, but that's not, people are letting go of all that and they're saying between us in our relationship, what works for us? Who's going to be able to make more money, or who's going to, how does this make sense? And I really love that we're breaking down all those walls. And so I think when people ask that question, for me it's kind of like, irritating, because it's, I think we should be able to be open to sort of evolving and taking turns and trading places.
But I think it's valuable to know like what your type is too. Like, cause I think like it took me a while to figure out what my type was, because I was just like, oh, I think my type is more like dominant or butch, because I was like, okay, I know that girl's a lesbian. You know what I mean? And it's harder, it was harder for me to be like attracted to feminine women because I was like, I think they're all straight girls. And so I was like nervous to then kind of, I don't know, ask some girl out, but I was like, she's totally straight, you know?
Anyway. And then now in retrospect.
Now in retrospect, my type is definitely more feminine.
Yeah, and I, from day one, always was very specific, like I was very specific in what my type, like I knew who I was interested in, who I wasn't, and I never really wanted to have to get ready with someone else or like share makeup.
Yeah, Brandy definitely, like part of the requirement of like our relationship is that she gets like 98% of the bathroom time. So whatever that means, dominant or submissive, as long as she has time in front of the mirror to get her shit together.
So to answer your question, she's the butch, I'm the femme, and we don't believe in labels. So it makes a lot of sense.
No labels.
We're all about evolution.
And Brandy's barefoot and pregnant.
Yeah.
Anyway, if you like this video, click like, thumbs up, subscribe if you haven't yet. What are you doing? Not subscribing?
Yeah, you're watching. You made it through the end of this video.
If you've made it this long, you better be pushing that. God, I'm so attacked.
And if you guys have more questions, please, we love the questions. We also love to hear where you're from because you guys created this hashtag for us, which is so awesome. You are in the family, hashtag in the family, and we really do feel that way. We've been getting to know so many of you from all around the world, and I don't know, we'd love to hear your take on the topic.
Yeah.
Because it's no judgment to anyone. I think some people are very, very specific, and I think some people are, you know, it's like there are many different levels on the spectrum.
It's no judgment. We'll just judge you after.
We'll talk about it in private. Okay,
bye. Blow the smoke up to the sky, so you will notice me. You can't look in my notebook. You can't look and you'll see pictures of you.